Thank you. the Statue of Liberty. What an amazing gift from France, and what a welcome sight to immigrants who, after a long and arduous journey, finally entered New York Harbor. If you went into the pedestal of the statue, you surely saw on the wall a bronze plaque on which are engraved the words of the sonnet by him. Harbor that Twin Cities frame. Keep, ancient lands, your storied pomp, cries she with silent lips. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. The wretched refuse of your teeming shore, send these, the homeless, tempest-tossed to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door.
I go.
peace, it is very easy to lose sight of why we Americans enjoy the freedoms that we have today. Since the founding of the United States, brave and selfless men and women have served in a variety of ways to protect these freedoms, often resulting in the ultimate sacrifice. The world is a dangerous place today, requiring more than ever the services of these men and women of our armed forces. It is altogether right and appropriate to recognize these men and women who have served and who are serving. And during this next song, the choir and orchestra will do just that. The choir is about to sing a terrific piece of music entitled A Salute to Our Patriots. It consists of the songs of the five branches of the armed forces, and here is how we would like this to work. When we sing the song from your branch of service, we very much would like for you to stand so that we may recognize you. If you are unable to stand, just raise your hand so we may see where you're sitting. And if for any reason the serviceman or woman is not here this evening, we would be delighted if a family member or friend would stand to represent that person. Then, when we have finished your song, we ask that you be seated or lower your hand once again. Now, I'll give you a little heads up. We're going to start with the Army. So if you were or are cavalry or artillery or a grunt in good old infantry, get ready to be recognized. So ladies and gentlemen, please join your choir and orchestra as they proudly present A Salute to Our Patriots.
Thank you.
1918, but didn't release it then. He revived it and revised it in 1938, when the world was 1 year away from the start of World War II. It was released on Armistice Day that year and was sung by Kate Smith, who made it her signature song. The song is in the form of a prayer. You'll hear the choir sing as we raise our voices in a solemn prayer. A prayer for God's blessing and peace for our nation, which is always welcome and needed. It has been used on a number of memorable occasions. One bittersweet moment occurred on July 21st, 2011, when it was played as NASA's final wake-up call for the space shuttle Atlantis, ending our country's 30-year shuttle program. A most memorable singing occurred during a live television broadcast on the evening of the September 11th, 2001 terror attacks. After addresses by the House and Senate leaders, members of Congress broke out into an apparently spontaneous verse of the song on the steps of the Capitol in Washington, D.C. Clearly, God Bless America helped bring comfort and hope to a shocked and grieving nation trying to process this attack on U.S. soil. The world remains a dangerous place today, just as it was in 1938 and in 2001. Think of the geopolitical events of the past several weeks. Listen to your choir sing this prayer for peace in a fractured world and draw comfort, hope, and inner peace from its lovely words.